That's true.
So let's get back to this story about the
scary face, the retarded child.
Sorry, I keep getting distracted. No, he was this guy. I think his name was Edward. He was like Mexican or something, and he had the most like intense cholo
Edward
face.
Safety scissors hands.
Yeah. Right, right. Yeah, they. Yeah. Fuck! I'm mad that wasn't me. He had the most intense like just pissed off, you know, cholo face.
Do you have the full mustache at like 12?
No, but I made friends with him in Spanish class, which was so funny.
Because you're both being the same level of Spanish. Yeah.
And he was like the sweetest guy. He was like a really nice guy. He was really into Jan Hammer. And I remember like talking to him about like Jan. I'm like, that's cool that you're into like... sort of a weird thing to be into, but that's cool. Jan Hammer is very talented.
I don't know Jan Hammer.
I don't know what that is.
Jan Hammer is, he was like a synth artist. He had like a background in like orchestral music or something.
Really?
Yeah, he was a symphony artist that got into producing theme songs for TV shows. So he did, I think.
Oh, he's like John Tesh?
He did Miami Vice.
Oh, hell
for sure.
Yes.
Uh-huh. He did the theme for Cocaine Cowboys.
Yes.
He did, I don't think he did Knight Rider, but like, you know, he scored Miami Vice. So there's all this shit that's, you know, specifically Jan Hammer stuff. But he had that scary face. And then there was a kid they called Retank who I don't even think was disabled because he had a barbed wire tattoo on his arm and he was like 19 and he fucking he would just drink Bailey's minis at lunch. He would just get drunk during school or whatever. But yeah, it was like the first day of spring and there was like a bush behind school. Me and my friends went to go have a cigarette and they're all out there eating the berries.
What kind of berries were they?
From a bush.
Probably the kind that result in like diarrhea in the classroom. Yeah. The teacher has to deal with that.
Just everyone starts diarrheaing themselves.
Yeah.
That fucking poor teacher.
They were all like, I mean, none of them were like seriously fucked up. It was like a mainstreaming program, so they were kids that were like, maybe they were dyslexic or something.
That makes the story so much better.
Yeah.
They're going out and eating berries.
Yeah.
They're not retarded.
Yeah.
They're not fully disabled.
I mean, they were like, you know, they had like developmental problems.
Right. So they were like half day special ed, half day regular.
Extremely cruel to make fun of them to their face and not, you know,
right,
sort of just snickering from an alley adjacent to the classroom that they used where they tried to learn in defiance of science.
I mean, just the image of them huddled on the, like, I just picture them not even using their hands, just going mouth first and just sucking berries off the tree.
Like deer.
Yeah, exactly.
couple of white-tailed speds. I can't bring myself to call actual disabled people the R word.
I gotcha.
You know?
I think so too.
That feels wrong. If you're calling, you know, a person that I just disagree with that probably suffers from some kind of mental illness, a retard in a harassment campaign online to make their life worse, that's okay. But if it's a development, it's an actual person with a disability, that's a little cruel.
That's mean.
You know, if it's a blogger that just cares about social issues and they happen to go about it in like kind of a hysterical way, by all means, you know, harass that person until they kill themselves. Despite the fact that they have great intentions and they just want to make the world a better place.